Yo, what's up, y'all? Your boy back. All right, man. So we getting the videos out. We knocking these albums back. I don't know why everybody want to drop these damn albums with 19 songs, 16 songs, 20 songs. What the hell y'all want from me, yo? No, I'm joking. I'm joking. I actually got more time than usual, which is weird. So I can actually get these videos out for y'all. So in today's video, I got y'all with the Pierre Bourne. What is the album called? The Life of Pierre 5. Fun fact, I've never listened to a project from Pierre Bourne besides this or outside of this project. So this will be my first time listening to a Pierre Bourne project. I'm hoping that this is good. Of course, I really, really enjoy Pierre Bourne's instrumentals and production, of course. I've never listened to something solely by him. So, I'm excited. I'm interested to see, what he brings to the table as far as, him. Whatever the hell that meant. Anyways, I'm done talking. First track on here, intro, play the freaking music.
Probably at the end of this month.
See, I'm tired of all the rides, George. I need a car. I don't want that new car.
All right, so that leads right into Switching Lanes featuring none other than Playboi Carti.
Yeah, too much money game. Bought a new chain. In a real way to call. Wanna switch lanes. For my birthday, I want more than you, babe. Fuck you any day. Make you scream my name. But my money can't fit in like it's lame.
Hey yo, I just want to say before we continue, one, love the instrumental. Second, Pierre is doing his thing on here. I love the flow. Third, as an audio engineer, please step away from the damn mic. The damn pops, yo. Lord, the stop. Relax, Dylan. Lower it. Relax. It's not that serious, but please. My gosh. Every time I hear a P, I get scared, yo.
Where the fuck on the model? In the back of the gang. In the Q-tips. Yeah, PL. Yeah, my slick. We get crack, keep the stacks. See, y'all need got gas. See, y'all need some flex. Get flex, smoke in the air. I'm a Dali. Yeah, the world Dali.
Baby, give me brain. Yeah, let me go insane.
You mean to tell me? Hold on, bro. Hold on. You mean to tell me that was it? That was it. That was Playboi Carti's verse. That was it. You know what? I'm thankful. I'm grateful. You spared us. You know what? Okay. All right. So next track, it transitions right into Hulu. That was that freaking Playboi Carti. You know what? Whatever. Switching lanes. That was a nice little starter track. Anyways, next track on here, Hulu. I need a deluxe version of this album. Listen, y'all know how I feel about deluxe versions, but I need a deluxe version of this album in particular, just the instrumentals. Please do exactly what Metro did for All Heroes, not All Heroes Wear Capes, whatever. Please, please, please do that for this. This instrumental is beautiful. Please, please, Pierre. Pierre, well, come up, please. Do it. All right, next track on here, Couch.
Extended, Yankees, I
niggas mad cause they suck. Alright, man. That was Couch. Next track on here, 42. It might just be me, but I think this song would be so much better chopped and screwed. Yeah. So, Shrellis, I think that I forgot how to say his name, but get on that, please. Thanks. Alright, that was 42. Next track on here, Biology 101. I love this damn album. Alright, if y'all couldn't tell by now, I love this album. We like, what, 6 tracks in? I love the album. Okay, 6-7 tracks in. I love this. Okay. Alright. I haven't come across a song that I don't like yet. Other than the fact that Playboi Carti verse was so damn short and he literally said nothing in this song. Other than that, bro, I love this album, okay? Yes, this album is great. And again, I need a deluxe version of just straight instrumentals. Facts. Hold on, y'all not gonna catch me like that. Transition right into YNS, you bum bitch. Alright, next track on here, Sauce Boy 2, featuring Lil Uzi Vert. Alright, man. Yo, that's some real questionable. There's some real questionable ass lines in that freaking song, yo. I don't know what Uzi was talking about. Something, yo, Uzi, what? And then next track, Practice. Practice. SpongeBob, my nigga Patrick, I got my guac, I got a mattress. Run and play like S&O, I got a gas like Texaco. My bitch look like Betty Boo, pay it just like Slowpoke. Austin Price, I steal my mojo, soldier boy, you stole my whole flow. I'm gonna cut like Neurosporin, yo. Oh my gosh! I'm sorry, man. Like, there's some daggone lines in here that make me think, like, yo, for real, bro? Oh my gosh, man. Just the last song. I think he was like, something about Simba and Roar, like. Then you got on this one, SpongeBob, my dude is Patrick. Like, word? That's the one you came up with, man? I mean, I'm in the cut like Neurosporin. Word? The instrumental was nice, though. I like it. I don't like the ad-lib, the whoa. I don't like that, though. That just scared me. Not gonna lie, had me clutching my purse, but it's all good, yo. It's all good. Next track on here, 40 Clip. No Alright, that's my problem with this album. It can be very, very freaking repetitive. Very, very repetitive. Now I'm understanding why these songs are so freaking long. Because for a minute I was trying to figure out, yo, why is damn near every song, you know, like 4 minutes and 30 seconds, close to 5 minutes, or almost at that exact point. And I'm like, oh, it's because he keeps freaking repeating himself 15 million times over. It just clicked in my head. Now I understand. You don't need to keep doing that shit. Damn, you cut these damn songs half off. Then put the freaking transition. By the way, love the transitions. Love them. Love them. Love them. The instrumentals, the transitions, great. I don't like this song, by the way. I don't. I'm not feeling it. It's not for me. Don't. Whatever. I don't care. I'm not a fan of this track right here. This song is not hitting at all. But again, I think that's my only negative takeaway from this album. It can get repetitive. But other than that, I think so far, this is my only song that I don't really like on this album. And if any of you have a problem with that, then I don't know what else I could tell you. Like, I reached track 10 and I only don't like one track. Is that a problem? So freaking be it. I mean, whatever. But anyways, I'm gonna keep listening to it though. Yeah, that song didn't hit at all. Next track on here, Retroville. Next track, Drunk and Nasty. Tell me something, what's on up? Get drunk and nasty, yeah. Wanna get drunk and nasty, yeah. Wanna get drunk and nasty, yeah. Wanna get drunk and nasty, drunk and nasty, yeah. Wanna get drunk and nasty, nasty. Wanna get drunk and nasty, nasty, yeah. Yeah. I be classy. Kill from the side of a penny. I'm rolling like Draco Degrassi. Alright, next track, Amen. I'm gonna tell y'all right now. I love the first 9 tracks on this album, and then we reach 40 clip, didn't like that. We reach Retroville, and then we reach Drunken Nasty, and now we at Drunken Nasty, and I'm trying to figure out what is happening to this album. So we on Amen now, and I'm starting to feel like the album should be cut right here. The album should be cut and we should not have to continue to listen to any more. That's just how I feel. Amen. What the hell happened to the freaking album? Yo, I was enjoying this album. I really was. Until we reached 40 clip. And now I'm sitting here thinking to myself, maybe it was all an illusion, son. Maybe I was dreaming. Maybe I was tripping. You know what I'm saying? Maybe I was bugging out. But nah, bro. Like, for real. Ever since we reached 40 clip, it's been ass. Ever since. Instrumental is still great, by the way. Still good. Don't know what this man is doing on these instrumentals at all. At all. And then the repetitiveness is killing me. Killing me softly, bro. Like, you're repeating yourself 8 times. Why? The songs are going on 5 minutes long. Why? You know what I'm saying? The transitions are there. Great. But it cut the songs and cut them up. This song is what? I want to say 3 minutes. That's cool compared to 5. In a row, but this song is ass.
I'm prepared.
Y'all already know, transition, whoop-de-whoop, into groceries, man. Alright, so that was groceries. I will say I enjoyed that extremely more than I did 40 Clip, Retroville, Drunk and Nasty, and Amen. The repetitiveness is still there, of course, but I still enjoyed that song way more than I did the last 1, 2, 3, 4 tracks. If all those 4 tracks were cut off and we just had to listen to groceries and these last 2, Butterfly and For You, then I'm cool. But, yeah, again, ever since 40 Clip, I've not been rocking with what's been going on in this, on this album. That's just me personally. Next track on here, Butterfly. Yeah. Anyways, last track on here, For You. Alright, so I'm gonna tell y'all right now. I definitely enjoyed this album in terms of its production. I still want a deluxe where it's just the instrumentals to this album. Definitely. The transitions on this album, amazing. But from 40 Clip to literally every single song I've heard except for Groceries is a skip. For me, personally, a skip. So last track on here for you. Alright, man. That was Pierre Bourne, The Life of Pierre 5. My first album from Pierre Bourne that I've listened to ever. So, my final review of my first reaction, I guess you would say. I guess let me get the bad stuff out the way first. As far as the bad, the stuff that I didn't like necessarily about the album, I didn't like how repetitive the album could be. Like, he literally, it got to the point where I could actually count it. He would repeat himself literally 8 times in a row before he would move on to either his verse or to the transition or to maybe the feature or whatever. But the repetitiveness would like, it was too much. it was actually too much, you know, and it got to a point where I started to ask myself again, like, yo, why are the songs so freaking long? You know, the songs definitely could have, all of the songs on this album, because of the instrumentals, right? And because of how many times he repeated himself, could have easily, all of the ambitions could have been cut 2 minutes. Down from 5 to 2, could have been 2 minutes, easy. Easy, 2 minutes. Because listen to what he's talking, like, bro, and if we're being real, he's not really saying much on some of the songs anyway. So it's like, does it really need to be 5 minutes? I don't think so. You know what I'm saying? Another thing that I didn't necessarily like on this album was, I guess, Playboi Carti. His feature was ass. I mean, like, it was complete ass. Again, when it comes to Playboi Carti and his features, it's either a hit or miss. Not only was his a miss, but it was a complete disaster, okay? Like, it was terrible. And he barely even had a feature at that. Like, it was short as a bitch, you know what I'm saying? So, there was that. I didn't like that. I didn't like the repetitiveness. I didn't like how long all of the songs were, you know, as far as the album went. And, I think that was really it, you know, And some of the songs, he just wasn't really saying anything that kept me really interested. The only thing that really kept me interested was the production, was the instrumentals, which leads me into the good parts of this album. The production, the instrumentals, the transitions of this album. I loved it. I love transitions of an album. I love that. Especially when you know you can incorporate that onto your live performances. Beautiful. You know, so as far as the transitions go, as far as production wise goes, it's great. You know what I'm saying? I don't have a problem on that end. And again, I would love a deluxe where it's just strictly instrumentals. From 40 clip onwards, and except for Groceries and For You, those songs were skips for me. I did not enjoy those songs at all. I did not think that they were anything that should have been on the album, to be honest with you, because they were just repetitive, like, nonsense, honestly. And, like, it would have been better off just being the instrumental to the song. You know, like, those songs did not do anything. Those songs held no weight compared to the rest of the album, in my honest opinion. You know what I'm saying? So, anyway, as far as the album goes, that's how I felt about it. Not a bad album at all, and I'm not calling this album trash. Just because I didn't like a couple of songs on this album for a first listen does not mean that I think this album is trash. Please do not think that I'm hating on this album or hating on Pierre or calling this album trash. Listen, you dumbass. I'm not saying this album is trash or garbage. I just didn't like those tracks, and that's all. You know what I'm saying? You can live with it or not. Whatever. Anyways, if you guys enjoyed today's video, do make sure to leave a like. Don't forget to subscribe for more. As always, Jonah Squad, thank you for watching. Follow me on all my socials, links in the description. Y'all be safe, y'all be easy. I'm gonna catch y'all in the next one. Peace.